And welcome in, everyone. We're getting ready for our final boys consolation semifinal of the day here on the, this is the 49th annual Lamar Holiday Basketball Tournament. It's the first time we've had it here on ColoradoPreps.tv and Chassa.tv. Kerry Sherman from Big Time Small Town Media. Our coverage from start to finish is sponsored this season by the Holiday Motel, located at 404 North Main here in Lamar. We're about to get the starting lineups. We wanted to get all of our, try to get our paperwork taken care of here, because we will be going rapid fire again. It's get down just in time to catch your breath and get the starting lineups from the coaches, get back in, get them fired up, and we are on the road constantly here. It's awesome. We're excited to be part of it. Let's look at the starting lineup. The visitors in the contest today will be Eads, their head coach, Justin McLeod, assistant coach, Jay Wilson. We'll roll with number one, Tyler Rouse, a 5'10 sophomore. Number three, Kyle Crow, he's a 6-foot senior. Number 22, Jose Ramos, a 5'11 senior. Number 24 is Logan Smith, a 6'1 senior. And number 30, Corey Miller, he is a 6-foot senior. We've had a change in the Walsh starting lineup from last night. Instead of Haciel Calzada, it'll be number 14, Christian Alvarez. He is a 5'10 junior. Number 12, Tanner Thompson. He is a 6'2 junior. Number 15, Chase Mundell, a 6-foot junior. Number 22, Jordan Jones, a 5'11 senior. And number 30, Chaz Hebbard, is a 6'2 junior. Hebbard got in early foul trouble yesterday. Just really struggled to get his groove. And Walsh had all kinds of problems with the pressure from McClave in their blowout loss. Mundell in the center circle in the white for Walsh. It's Rouse, number one, in purple for Eads. Rouse steals the tip, and Crow will initiate the offense first time down the floor. Feed inside for Ramos, lost it going up. Rouse tracks it down, gives it off to Crow. Eads had a tough defeat. Lost 56-51 to Grenada late last night. They led for most of that contest and couldn't stop Grenada once they got rolling in the fourth quarter. Miller powers one up with the left, no good. Rebound, Ramos tied up. Possession arrow for Walsh here. 30 seconds in. This is our fourth consolation semifinal of the day. We've had two on the girls' side. This is our second boys' one. After this, we'll have a bit of a break and then fire up with championship semifinals. Floater in the paint for Christian Alvarez. Coach Rehnquist put him into the starting lineup today. Knocked out of bounds on the near sideline by Walsh. Ramos has to go into the backcourt to retrieve the inbounds. Miscommunication, Rouse and Miller. Miller started the cut, Rouse threw it to the corner. It's a turnover. Alvarez at the point, looking at the 2-3 zone from Eads. Mundell got a bump, floated it inside Hebbard. Up and will not go, fighting for his own miss. Comes out of there with it. And Mundell will set things back up with Jones. Skip pass for Mundell. Feed inside. Hebbard stripped going up. Miller called for the foul. That was the first foul of the contest. It comes a minute 45 in. Hebbard will head to the free throw line for two shots. First one off the mark. Second free throw for Hebbard. That will roll home. 3-0 is the Walsh start. And that one bounces on the sidelines. Slow start, nothing new for Eads. They trailed Grenada. I don't remember if it was 8-0 or 10-0 last night. It was an 8-0 lead for Grenada right out of the blocks. And Eads plugged away. And almost down 6-0 there. Jones couldn't knock it down. The tip wouldn't follow. Miller from the free throw line. Too strong. Smith with the board. He had to hit a three yesterday to get him started. Crow will try one off glass. No. Alvarez with the board for Walsh. Looking to push. Jones up ahead. Blocked by Miller and Rouse with the board for Eads. Rouse drives, splits the defenders off glass, no. Mundell picks the rebound up off the bounce. Alvarez, he'll fire three, good. Alvarez has five. Making Coach Rehnquist smile a bit, making that change to put him in the lineup. Rouse misses the layup. And Walsh will come back with it. Alvarez fakes the three. Tried to drive. Bumped by Crow. That'll be the first on Kyle Crow. It's the second foul against Eads. That's a turnover. Ramos with the ball for Eads. Crow scoops one up off glass and good. That'll get Eads on the board. It was a 6-0 start for Walsh in the first half of this quarter. Now Eads on the board. Alvarez, he'll fire from 22. Nylon City. We're going to get a timeout on the Eads side. It's a 30-second one. 3:44 to play. Christian Alvarez with 8 points in this first quarter. Change in the lineup for Eads. We see number 20, Dylan Dixon, in there. But it's a turnover. Jones looking at it. Ball tipped out of bounds. Mundell drive. Kick out. Alvarez three. Not this time. Jump ball called. Possession goes to Eads. Looking at that seven-point deficit. And Crow nearly has it stolen and finally does. It's Thompson. Kicks it over Alvarez. Into the paint. Up, no. Mundell in there just flips it out to Alvarez. Mundell for three from the corner. That's good. It's a 10-point lead for Walsh. Trying to get it in to Miller. Tipped out of there by Hebert. It's stolen. Alvarez may have got a thumb in the eye. And the official is going to take a stoppage to check him out. He says, I'm all right. And the officials will let him stay in. Got 2 minutes and 10 seconds still to play here in the first quarter. And Crow is going to be whistled for his second foul. Logan Crawford hustling to the table as he'll check in. Alvarez, he'll rim that three out. Thompson with the board. Jones has the open look. He'll cash that one. And Jones hustling after that one, knocks it out of bounds. Miller fouled on the drive. He'll go to the free throw line. That's on Hebert. That's his first. That's the first one against Walsh here in this quarter. Miller. First free throw is short. Rene Salcido will replace Hebert. He's wearing number 32 for Walsh. Second one, no good as well. Crawford pokes it out of bounds. One, three, one now, so Walsh will go to a two-guard set. Thompson, kick it out, Mundell. Skip. Mundell from 15, no. And Miller with the board for Eads. Minute 15 to play in the opening quarter. Ramos, kick out. Smith, three, good. That'll cut it to a 10-point game. Closing out 50 seconds left in the frame. Thompson alone underneath, gets the layup. Dixon gets it across to Crawford. Had a man open underneath. Jones with the steal. Drive. It's going to be a block on Dixon. That's the first one on Dixon. He checks out, as does Smith. Rouse checks back in, and we see the first appearance for number 10, Trent Michek, today. Jones fires the three, short. Miller with the rebound. Quickly ahead, Ramos looking for the breakout. Mundell hustling back, gets a piece of the arm as Ramos goes up. So Jose Ramos heads to the free throw line with 16.6 seconds to go. First foul against Mundell. Ramos cashes the first free throw. Gets them both. Back to a 10-point game. Miller with the steal of the overpass. Down to 6 seconds to go. Rouse looking at it. Gives it over to Ramos. Michek will fire the three at the buzzer and get it. Trent Michek meets the buzzer. Cuts it to a 17-10 lead for Walsh after one quarter.
At the Anton Co-op, they're a local farmer-owned. The Holiday Motel, a historical stop on the Santa Fe Trail, proudly presents you the Lamar Holiday Classic on Big Time Small Town Media. Located at 404 North Main Street in Lamar, get a room to suit all your needs with a full-size bed, a king bed, or a suite with two king-size beds by calling 719-336-9754. Each room has a microwave, refrigerator, free Wi-Fi, and DirecTV with over 130 channels. So the next time you're headed down the Santa Fe Trail, think the Holiday Motel, a family-run business. Proud to present you the Lamar Holiday Classic on Big Time Small Town Media.
With more than 30 years in business, Pro Sports is the only place teams need to go to outfit for this season. A complete supplier of team athletic apparel, teams get their uniforms and equipment at a team discounted price. Outfit your team with Pro Sports, located in downtown Sterling, but a proud supplier to teams from all across Colorado. Pro Sports, offering team discounts. Call now, 970-522-8545, and outfit your team today. Pro Sports, your team source.
Second quarter underway. Walsh with the ball, shot up, no good. Ramos with the rebound for Eads. He brings it up. Kicks it into the corner. Nice feed inside. Crawford is fouled. That's called on Hebert, his second. That is the third team foul against Walsh here. Jones comes in back in place of Hebert. See the first appearance of number 10, Haciel Calzada. He was in the starting lineup last night. Crawford powers it up and in. Cuts it down to five. Mundell off the fake. Floater. No. The thing stayed on the back of the rim as long as it could before it reached checkout time. Drive by Miller. Scoop. No. Rebound out into the hands of Calzada. Miller punches it out of bounds. Mitchett checks out. Smith will take his place in the Eads lineup. Nice feed inside. Thompson was a little too deep and could not make the reverse. Knocked out of bounds by Eads. Thompson from a little better angle this time knocks down the jumper, his second field goal. Puts it back to the 7-point lead. Skip pass. Smith puts it on the floor. Steps through. Off glass, no good. Thompson with the board. And gives it off to Alvarez, who looks to push. Has his pocket pick, but it's a reach-in foul from behind. Whistled on Ramos. His first, number five against Eads in the half. Pass too tall for Calzada, and Crawford wins the race to the loose ball. Crawford turn, offensive foul. Thompson holds his ground. And Hebbard comes in for Calzada. Eads will run the 1-3-1 on this trip defensively. Mundell with the open look from three. That's off the mark. Out of bounds off of Hebbard. Little half-court trap action from Walsh. And Eads beats it. Miller couldn't make the layup on the drive. Walsh quickly ahead. Jones. Skip it over for Thompson off the fake. Nice feed inside. Hebbard using the rim and his body to shield the off the defender. And he'll knock it home. His first field goal. Lead up to nine. And a steal for Mundell. It's a 4-on-3. Mundell pulls up from eight. Off glass. Good. Soft touch off the back of the rim for Chase Mundell. He has five. Lead is 11, 23-12. Rouse splits the double team, gets it off to Miller. Nice feed, finds Smith, and Smith lets traffic clear, banks one home. He has five. Thompson in the short corner, dump inside. Hebbard kick it out. Alvarez, fake, puts it up, no good. Ramos finds the loose ball rebound. Smith gets the three out of the corner. That one's off the mark, and Hebbard with the rebound. Just about to hit the half point of this quarter, and it's a full timeout taken by Walsh. We'll go ahead and step away ourselves here for just 30 seconds.
There she goes again.
What was that in the cereal aisle?
Mrs. Speedley with her Viero 4G smartphone.
Who?
Mrs. Speedley gets all the sales coupons on her smartphone on the Viero 4G network, knows everything that's on sale. The fastest shopper we have.
She's at the 2-for-1 soda display. No, dollar off salad dressing. No, discount candy.
If you want to do things you love faster and better, switch to Viero's 4G network today. Stuck in a contract? Don't worry. Viero will even pay your early termination fee. Hurry in, because Viero now has the iPhone for only $39.99. That's smart. That's fast. That's Viero. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
We have 4:03 on the clock here in the second quarter. Walsh on top of Eads by a 23-14 score. And Walsh will have it at midcourt. Facing the 1-3-1 zone. Thompson's turnaround into the side of the backboard. And Eads comes down with it. Looking to cut into that 9-point deficit they see. 3.5 minutes to go. Tipped back towards the timeline. Smith hauls it in. Looks like a 2-3 from Walsh. Whipping it around the perimeter. Smith gets the 3 look. Mundell with the rebound. And Walsh pushing. Feed inside. Thompson layup good and the foul. Foul called on Miller is his second. Haciel Calzada will replace Hebbard for Walsh. Dixon came into the Eads lineup. Free throw for Thompson is good. 5 in the quarter. He has 7 now. The lead is a dozen. We tick down to 3 minutes to play here in the first half. Crow tries his hand at a 3. It's off. Smith, offensive rebound, step through and score it on the putback. Cuts it back to 10. Smith has 7 in the half. Nice feed inside. Thompson come up short, but he's fouled again. That one by Rouse. That's the first on Rouse. Thompson will shoot 2. That was the 7th team foul against Eads in the half. Thompson's free throw too strong. Second one on its way. That one also too strong. Miller tries to save it. It'll be tied up, and Arrow gives it back to Eads. 2:27 to play before break. Eads able to break the trap and then turn it over. It's Alvarez. Only Miller to beat. Miller from behind swats it out of bounds. Calzada gives it off to Jones. Up top now for Alvarez. Jones. Skip it over for Alvarez. Pull up from 12. No good. Jones offensive rebound. Tapped it to himself. Off the side of the backboard to himself. And tipped out. He'll track it down on the far side. Calzada gets the open look. That one's off. And Smith. His pass kicked. It'll stay with Eads. Crow. We'll get a breather here with 1:39 to play as Michek comes in. Whipping it around the 2-3 defense. Float inside. Miller powers it up. No good. Offensive rebound for Michek. He is fouled. Looks like they're going to say on the floor. It's called on Mundell. That'll be his second. 4th team foul of the half. Crawford will replace Miller for Eads. Salcido replaces Calzada on the Walsh side. Crawford into the paint, puts one up the bottom side of the rim, and rebound pulled down by Walsh. Quickly ahead, Mundell layup, good. Nice touch on the floater. Mundell with 7, 60 seconds to play in the half. Lead is back to a dozen. Rouse, pull-up jumper, good. It's his first basket. Alvarez has his shot blocked by Crawford. Well, we're going to get a whistle against Crawford. Be his second. Alvarez will shoot two. First one off. Calzada replaces Mundell for Walsh. Too strong. Mitchek with the board. Rouse hits it ahead for Smith. Smith nearly travels with it. Down to 12 seconds. Rouse will give it off to Mitchek. He hit a buzzer beater at the end of the first. Will Eads do it again? No, nope, because Alvarez will steal it. Calzada will not beat the clock. We go to the half with Walsh in front of Eads, 28-18. We will allow the teams and officials to exit the floor and then step out for a three-minute break. We'll be back in about 3 minutes here from the Lamar Community Building here in the Lamar Holiday Basketball Tournament's 49th edition.
Hi, I'm Ben Blecka, owner, founder, and one of the talents of Big Time Small Town Media. The broadcast you're seeing today is a production of Big Time Small Town Media. Just 1 year ago, a group of Northeast Colorado sports broadcasters started something we hoped would bring extra joy to the athletes participating in the games we were already covering on radio. It has turned into a service we provide for not only Northeast Colorado athletes, but athletes statewide, region-wide, and internationally who request our services. We do straight-to-DVD production in addition to live internet productions of any event who wants Big Time Small Town Media to be a part of their community. Because Big Time Small Town Media is more than just sports. It's community. Are you interested in the services Big Time Small Town Media can provide your upcoming event? I encourage you to contact me at ben@bigtimesmalltown.com. You can see some of the many events we've done in the past year at ihi.com/bigtimesmalltown. And I encourage you, think about Big Time Small Town Media being a part of your community with whatever upcoming events you've got.
Hello, Jen's dorm room. You know Jen's bright. That's why she's double majoring. And why, when it came time to open an account, she chose free checking from Bank of Colorado. She did her homework and learned Bank of Colorado's free checking is the real deal. With free online bill pay, free debit card, and no hidden fees. It makes sense to Jen and to us. Apply online at bankofcolorado.com. Bank of Colorado, the way banking should be. Member FDIC.
Ever dreamed of having the right answer at just the moment you need it? Then get the iPhone 4S. It's not just a smartphone, it's your own personal assistant. And it's now available at Vieira Wireless. The iPhone 4S includes phenomenal new features such as an ultra-sharp, high-resolution display, 8-megapixel high-def camera, and a souped-up processor for speedy performance. And the iPhone 4S actually listens. Ask her a question, she'll have an answer. So stop dreaming and get the iPhone 4S with our fast 4G network now at Vieira. Restrictions apply. See store for details.
Ice and Oil has been supporting our community for over 65 years and is the leading supplier in propane, Sinclair Diesel and Gas, Chevron Oils, Greases and Lubricants, and a variety of tires and Delco batteries. Located on Highway 34 in Otis and Plattner, Ice and Oil is your number one source for diesel, oil, gas, and propane needs. For all those road trip adventures through Northeast Colorado, they offer 24-hour pay-at-the-pump gas and diesel services. Ice and Oil, American product, American quality, affordable prices.
Glossing Construction is your one-stop shop with concrete work, drywall, flooring, roofing, and stucco. Everything including the final finishing nail handle projects throughout northeastern Colorado. You need to get in touch with Rick at Glossing Construction, located at 801 East 4th Street in Akron. If Rick can't build it, no one can. Call 970-345-2087. From start to finish, trust Glossing Construction as your one-stop shop for construction. Call 970-345-2087.
Ooh, welcome back, everyone. Kerry Sherman here at halftime. Lips are on fire here. We had us a little bite of some, I think it's Demon's Revenge brisket here. Whew. That is some spicy stuff here. It's good, but you know, we are at halftime here of our final boys consolation semifinal. It is Walsh in front of Eads as Eagles face Eagles. We'll look at scoring. Starting with Eads, 2 points from Tyler Rouse, 2 by Kyle Crow, 3 from Trent Michek, 2 from Jose Ramos, 7 out of Logan Smith, and 2 points from Logan Crawford. For Walsh, it is 7 points by Tanner Thompson, 8 out of Christian Alvarez, 3 from Jordan Jones, 3 from Chaz Hebbard, and 7 from Chase Mundell. Big storyline is the performance of Christian Alvarez. Did not start yesterday. Instead, it was Haciel Calzada. Coach Rehnquist inserting Alvarez into the lineup today, and 8 first quarter points. He made his head coach look like a genius with that. As a coach, you love it when you make a decision like that and it works out for you that well. In Eads, they played a late one last night. That game with Grenada finished up, I believe it was close to 11 o'clock time. That one came to a conclusion. Lost it in heartbreaking fashion. And now trying to get their legs back under them. Hasn't been a great first half. See what kind of changes are made in the locker room. See if they can make an early run here to start the third quarter and get themselves back into it. We've seen a lot of big leads at halftime evaporate already, and we're not even halfway through the tournament here. Go ahead and take another 3-minute break as we get ourselves ready for the second half. Hope you stick with us here from the Lamar Community Building, the 49th annual Lamar Holiday Basketball Tournament.
Hi, I'm Ben Blecka, owner, founder, and one of the talents of Big Time Small Town Media. The broadcast you're seeing today is a production of Big Time Small Town Media. Just 1 year ago, a group of Northeast Colorado sports broadcasters started something we hoped would bring extra joy to the athletes participating in the games we were already covering on radio. It has turned into a service we provide for not only Northeast Colorado athletes, but athletes statewide, region-wide, and internationally who request our services. We do straight-to-DVD production in addition to live internet productions of any event who wants Big Time Small Town Media to be a part of their community. Because Big Time Small Town Media is more than just sports. It's community.
Thank you. In 1916, it is estimated that producing 100 bushels of corn took approximately 35 to 40 hours. Today, it is estimated that producing the same 100 bushels takes less than 3. A lot has changed in the last 95 years, but one thing has stayed the same. Farm Credit is still the lender of choice for America's farmers and ranchers. We are passionate about agriculture and are dedicated to serving America in good times and bad. This is Jordan Wilkie in the Yuma Lending Office. Give us a call today to see how we can help you. Premier Farm Credit, the gold standard in ag lending.
This broadcast of high school sports is being brought to you courtesy of the Allen Bear Agency of Akron. In times of such economic uncertainty, let Allen Bear and his staff serve as stability when it comes to your insurance needs. With years of experience serving their community with products in auto, home, and life insurance, the Allen Bear Agency is also available for farm, crop, business, and health insurance as well. Give Allen and his team a call today at 970-345-2310 or stop into 142 Adams in Akron to see how the Allen Bear Agency can serve you.
The Holiday Motel, a historical stop on the Santa Fe Trail, proudly presents you the Lamar Holiday Classic on Big Time Small Town Media. Located at 404 North Main Street in Lamar, get a room to suit all your needs with a full-size bed, a king bed, or a suite with two king-size beds by calling 719-336-9754. Each room has a microwave, refrigerator, free Wi-Fi, and DirecTV with over 130 channels. So the next time you're headed down the Santa Fe Trail, think the Holiday Motel, a family-run business. Proud to present you the Lamar Holiday Classic on Big Time Small Town Media.
I'm Roy Dinsdale, founder of Bank of Colorado. All you hear these days are ads about gold. Gold has been around forever, and I darn near have. But what is more precious to us than gold is our reputation. And that is why for over 70 years, we put our customers first. We think that's the way banking should be. And at Bank of Colorado, we'll continue to be. Visit us at bankofcolorado.com. Member FDIC.
Get your DVD copies of The Adventure Scene live online at BigTimeSmallTown.com. Hi, I'm Ben Blacka, owner, founder, and one of the talents of Big Time Small Town Media. Very glad you're enjoying the broadcast we're bringing to you live online. But don't forget, you can have this broadcast whenever and wherever you want with a purchase of the DVD from Big Time Small Town Media. Go to www.BigTimeSmallTown.com. There you can check out all of the games that we've got from any past tournaments. We've been doing this for just more than a year, and Big Time Small Town Media is proud to be more than sports. We're community.
Ready to get the second half underway here. We'll get the starting lineups as quickly as we can. Get back on our feet here. Walsh ball to start it. And a turnover. For Eads, it is Rouse, Crow, Ramos, Smith, and Miller, five who started for them. Working against the man defense by Walsh. That's Miller with it. Turn into the paint, hangs, took the bump, drops the basket, heads to the free throw line. Foul called on number 15, Chase Mundell, his third. The lineup out there for Walsh right now. Oh, it's about to change because Mundell's going to head to the bench. He's replaced by Haciel Calzada out there with Thompson, Alvarez, Jones, and Hebbard. Free throw is good for Miller. It's a three-point play. And just like that, it's down to a seven-point game. About 40 seconds played. Eads in that 2-3 zone. Calzada floater in the paint. No. Miller with the rebound after it was tapped to him. And Crow will push for Eads. Miller finds Crow on the backside, and Kyle Crow knocks it home. Caught the defense asleep. Able to sneak in behind Jones for that layup. Take it down to five. Calzada, that one swatted out by Miller. Ramos tries to save it. Hebbard with it now. And Ramos reaching in, called for his second foul. Well, each team whistled for a foul here, and we haven't played 2 minutes yet. Hebbard has it stripped. Rouse on the floor. They'll call the travel on him. Jones eyeing the defense. Skip pass. Alvarez into the paint. Had it knocked loose. Smith with it. Crow is the one who knocked it loose. Eads trying to further cut that 10-point deficit down. Not with that shot. Three missed by Crow. Walsh with the rebound. Ahead. Jones misses the two. Hebbard fouled. Oh, and I don't know if he got in the face or what. He was rolling around in pain for a moment. Hebbard will shoot two. The foul whistled on Smith is his first. That one comes up short. Calzada checks out. Salcido in. Ramos checks out of Eads' lineup, and Crawford comes in. Hebbard's second free throw attempt. That one's good. He's up to 4 points in the contest. Pushes the lead back to six. Looking at the 2-3, Rouse calls out the offense. Skip it for Smith. Now Crow fakes the three. Floater off glass, draws a foul. Foul was called on Jones, his first, the second on the team. Crow to the free throw line for two. Too strong. Second one. That one's good. Crow now has five. That's the difference in the game. Walsh by five. Again, we want to remind people that we will have all of the games from this tournament available on demand at coloradopreps.tv and chassa.tv as quickly as we can get them uploaded. That three off the mark, tracked down by Jones, saved it to Thompson. Jones on the drive, foul. See if they get Miller or Rouse. Miller from the front, Rouse from behind. It is on Miller. That'll be his third. Jones to the line for two shots. And we have to have a minimum upload speed. We've not been able to achieve it just yet down here. We'll try it when we get back to the motel tonight. And if not, we will have them up when we get home later this weekend. Check them off and on throughout. We will hope to have everything up by Monday afternoon. Three from Crow is off. Smith kick out. Miller has it knocked loose, and it's a steal for Walsh. Kick off for Hebbard. Ends up being a pass to Salcido. Misses it. And tie up on the rebound between Salcido and Smith. Arrow favors Eads. We've got a sub coming to the table. Chase Mundell replaces Salcido. And Eads will bring it up, 4:20 to play, third quarter. 2-2-1, half trap, floated into the middle, and that's where Thompson standing for the defense. Walsh gets the steal. Feed inside, Hebbard travels with it before Crow can reach in. Ramos will replace Rouse in the Eads lineup. Looking over the top this time, Crawford finds Smith. Smith hangs and knocks the layup home. 9 for Logan Smith. That's tops on Eads. Alvarez whips it down for Thompson. And loose ball, finally corralled by Alvarez. He'll drive, runs into Smith, floats one up. Crawford, his save right to Miller, takes one dribble, pulls it up, gives it off to Crow. Crow has it poked from behind. Mundell with it, trying to push tempo. Forces one up, draws the whistle. That's on Crow, his third, and the fourth on the team. First free throw is good. Calzada and Salcido come back in for Walsh. Mundell misses the second. Smith with the board for Eads. As we hit the 5 minutes played point of this third quarter, it's a 5-point lead. Smith trying to make it two, cannot. Salcido with the board for Walsh. Quickly up ahead, Mundell. Pulls the trigger on the three, fouled by Smith. The second on Smith. They'll say he was no longer an airborne shooter. It was on the box out. So take it on the side. That is, however, the fifth team foul against Eads. Alvarez drive, floater, good. He's into double figures, has 10. That is tops in the game. Smith has it stripped on the baseline by Hebbard. He tries to lead the break. It's 3-on-2. Made the pass. Oops, and Miller hit the deck. Mundell, beneficiary of the pass. He now has 10. Lead is back up to 9. Crawford from the baseline. That's no good. Ramos in there fighting for it, and I believe they're going to tag him with the foul. His third. Midcheck and Dixon will come in for Eads. Crow and Smith exit. A timeout, I believe, by Eads. Full timeout. That's the second timeout they've taken. When we'll get back on the floor, we've got 1:46 to play in the quarter. Eads has closed it down to five a couple of times. Right now, it's Walsh on a bit of a run. They've pushed it back out to nine. Walsh bringing it up the floor, looking now at the 1-3-1 zone. Into Hebbard, powers one up and gets it home. Lead back into double figures now at 11. Eads working against the 2-3 into Miller's turn. Little lefty scoop is good, and he draws the foul. It's called on Salcido. His first, team's third. Miller to the line. The and one is short. Tapped around. Mundell finally corrals it for Walsh. Ahead for Calzada, too far ahead and out of bounds. And a change of defense. Looks like they'll go. It's just been a change of the personnel placing. Miller with the layup. It's back to seven. 45 seconds to play in the quarter. In the middle, Calzada kick out. Now Jones, he spots up from 17, rims out. Hebbard on the inside. No, gets that one. Hebbard has five in the frame. Eight now for the game, and we're down to the final 15 seconds of this third quarter. Crawford trying to find Miller, cutting down the lane. It was stolen. Unselfish pass from Jones, but it's too unselfish. 1 second, Ramos from just inside midcourt. Off the glass, off the rim, no good. Three quarters played, and Walsh leads Eads by nine.
There she goes again.
What was that in the cereal aisle?
Mrs. Speedley, with her Viero 4G smartphone.
Who?
Mrs. Speedley gets all the sales coupons on her smartphone on the Viero 4G network, knows everything that's on sale. The fastest shopper we have.
She's at the 2-for-1 soda display. No, dollar off salad dressing. No, discount candy.
If you want to do things you love faster and better, switch to Viero's 4G network today. Stuck in a contract? Don't worry. Viero will even pay your early termination fee. Hurry in, because Viero now has the iPhone for only $39.99. That's smart. That's fast. That's Viero. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
And it's Walsh ball to start things here in fourth quarter action. They lead by nine over Eads. And the floater on the baseline by Hebbard will make it an 11-point advantage once again. Crawford trying to get it over to Ramos. He was wide open on the back side, but the pass hit the side of the backboard. Mundell's layup swatted out of bounds by Miller. Little misunderstanding on the Walsh side, but able to get into the backcourt and get the inbounds pass before Ramos got there. Missed the three. Stay on offense. Thompson finds Hebert camped inside. Misses the shot. Crow called for the foul. Coach McLeod asking for a three-second violation. It did look like Hebert was in there for a while. That is the fourth on Kyle Crow. Chaz Hebert to the free throw line. Cam's the first one. He has 11 in the contest. And that's the game-high total, surpassing the 10 by Alvarez and Mundell. Now a dozen for Hebert. Working against the full-court press and tipped out of bounds by Walsh. Now setting it at a three-quarter court, 2-2-1. Miller down the sideline. And Eads will look to score on the three by Crawford. Not there. Hebert putting a lock on the glass. Mundell running the court. Tipped it to Thompson. Thompson had to peel back to get it and steps on the sideline. Into the middle, Miller. Ahead, Ramos, skip pass, tipped out of there by Mundell. 6.5 to play. It's a 13-point advantage for Walsh. Sub coming to the table is Salcido in place of Thompson for Walsh. They'll flatten down that 2-3 zone. Try to force everything out. Crow has it. Rouse starts the drive, kick out. Crow goes, runs right into Jones, and that will be the fifth foul on Kyle Crow. That is his fifth, and he exits with 6:16 to play. 5 points scored in the contest. Dixon will replace him. Eads setting in their 2-3 zone. Walsh whipping it around, finds Hebert inside. Salcido misses. Hebert follow, foul going up. Oh, they're going to call. Called out on Hebert for pushing. That'll be his third. Thompson came back in. He replaces Hebert. Eads breaks the press. Three out of the corner for Smith. No good. Offensive rebound, Miller. Forces one up. Drew a whistle on Tanner. Thompson, his first. Fifth team foul, Miller to the free throw line. He's just 1-for-4 from the stripe today. Gets that one. Hebert replaces Salcido. Just a quick breather for Chaz Hebert. Second one for Miller is good as well. He's now got 9 points in the contest. We're down to 5.5 minutes to play. It's an 11-point game for Walsh. Elbow jumper, Jones, short, Hebbard brings it out and loses it into the front row on the far side. Walsh will bring out the 2-2-1. And it looks like Alvarez will be called on the elbow of the when Miller passed it. His first. That's the sixth foul against Walsh in the half. We're closing in on 5 minutes to go. Dixon's pass deflected by Mundell. Kick out for Dixon. Three is good. Dylan Dixon's first basket. And that cuts it down to eight. Walsh has just been unable to put Eads away. Had several opportunities. Put back by Hebbard. That won't go. Tipped around. Finally, Jones. That comes up short. Hebbard, too aggressive going for the board. And that's a foul. His fourth. We'll walk to the other end to shoot free throws. Actually, we're going to take a timeout first. It's a 30-second timeout by Walsh. .426 to play. Not positive who's heading to the free throw line, but it'll be a 1-1 for one of the Eads players. Chance to further narrow this deficit. It currently sets at 8. I believe the large lead for Walsh was a dozen. It's Ramos at the free throw line. Hit two in the first quarter, and that's been his scoring so far. Drains the first one. Second one is good as well. He has four. The lead for for Walsh is 6. Walsh moving it around the perimeter of this 2-3. Hebbard and Thompson keep taking turns stepping in on the back side of the zone. As the three guards play keep away outside. Hebbard inside, turnaround over Miller is good. He has 14 now. It's an 8-point advantage for Walsh. 3.5 minutes to play. And Alvarez will come up with a steal. Ahead is Mundell. Quick layup. Good. Mundell has a dozen. And the lead back to 10. In a blink of an eye. Ramos give it back to Dixon. Roush tries to drive. Floats one off the glass and falls. Second field goal for Roush. Back to an 8-point game. And Eads now matching up. 2:40 to play. Alvarez drive, floats, no, tapped out. And we're going to get a tie-up. Mundell and Dixon. Possession arrow in favor of Eads. 2.5 minutes to play. Try to get this back under 8 again. We get a timeout. It's a full timeout by Eads. We'll step out for the 60 seconds as well here from the Lamar Holiday Holiday Basketball Tournament.
Hi, I'm Ben Blecko, owner, founder, and one of the talents of Big Time Small Town Media. The broadcast you're seeing today is a production of Big Time Small Town Media. Just 1 year ago, a group of Northeast Colorado sports broadcasters started something we hoped would bring extra joy to the athletes participating in the games we were already covering on radio. It has turned into a service we provide for not only Northeast Colorado athletes, but athletes statewide, region-wide, and internationally who request our services. We do straight-to-DVD production in addition to live internet productions of any event who wants Big Time Small Town Media to be a part of their community. Because Big Time Small Town Media is more than just sports. It's community. Are you interested in the services Big Time Small Town Media can provide your upcoming event? I encourage you to contact me at ben@bigtimesmalltown.com. You can see some of the many events we've done in the past year at ihi.com/bigtimesmalltown. And I encourage you, think about Big Time Small Town Media being a part of your community with whatever upcoming events you've got.
And Eads will have the ball, 2:33 to go, trailing by 8. Walsh showing the possibility of some half-court pressure here. Extend it just a little further. And Ramos looking at the defense, sees it is man. Dixon will come to the point. Miller, they clear the side for him, tries to drive, spin into the paint, loses it on the floor. Ramos had it, lost it, tie up, arrow goes to Walsh. So clock down to 2:05. That's still an 8-point lead for Walsh. And knocked out of bounds by Miller. See Coach McLeod telling a couple of his players to switch their defensive assignments. Dixon has the assignment of Alvarez. Alvarez gets past the shoulders. Layup good. Alvarez has a dozen. Once he got his shoulders past the shoulders of his defender, it was just a matter of getting to the rim. From the short corner, find the cutter. That's Miller with the basket. He has 11. Still an 8-point game, minute 20 to play. Dixon diving in, knocking it out of bounds. It'll go stay with Walsh. They go into the backcourt for it. Smith will replace Crawford. Dixon diving for the steal. They'll say he grabs wrist on his way by. It's kind of hustle you love out of a player. That's a freshman. That's the ninth foul against Eads in the half. Second one on Dixon, and Alvarez to the free throw line. Missed his only two shots there today. And misses again. Hebbard can't hit the follow, pulls it out. Goes into the post for Mundell, kick out. Pulls up from 15 and knocks it home. Miller drives. They'll call the block on Hebbard. And that will do it. Chaz Hebbard will foul out on that. Yeah, they called it on 22. I don't see Jones even involved in the play. But he'll take the foul. That'll be his second. Miller to the free throw line. 54.4 seconds to go. It's a 10-point game. Hits the first. Timeout taken, I believe, by Eads. It's signal called Eads. It's a full timeout. And as soon as this one comes to a conclusion, we'll have just short of an hour intermission before we get back to live action, where we will start our girls' championship semifinals. Take a look at our brackets and get you at 5 o'clock. We're scheduled to have Wiley and Springfield on the girls' side. And then we'll drop over on the boys for a 6:30 Wiley and Holly matchup. Jump up on top on the girls' side. It's McClave and Kit Carson. And our final contest of the night would be McClave and Grenada on the boys' side. Looking forward to some exciting matchups in our evening session. And hope you'd come back and join us for those. Miller's second free throw, good. He's got 13 points all since the break. And Miller will give up a foul on Hebbard. That'll be the fourth on Miller. There's 47 seconds left on the clock. Hebbard can't get the first one. Still has the second. So we're in the penalty situation on this end of the floor. Second one to make it a 9-point game. That's good. He has 7 in the quarter, a dozen after the break. Rouse, long three is short. Dixon hustling after it, but it hits a support. Goes out of bounds. 36 and a half seconds to go. And Smith will check out. Mitchek in. A 9-point lead for Walsh. I'll cover it up. And Mundell will walk down to shoot the penalty. Rouse called for his second. Smith will come back to the table. Trying to extend the game, going offense for defense. Mundell's first free throw, no good. Smith replaces Mitchek. Second free throw for Mundell is good. Pushes it back to a 10-point game. Eads desperately needing a basket on this trip. Smith drives. Step back off the side of the backboard. Thompson with the rebound. 21 seconds to go. And this one is pretty much decided. Called on Smith, his third. Well, Thompson will shoot the penalty this time. That free throw gets him to double digits with 10. See sub coming to the table. Number 21, Cody Alton. Alton is a 5'6 senior. He'll come in for the final 21 seconds. Mitchek came back in for Eads. Second free throw. Tanner Thompson is too strong. Rouse with the rebound. He'll push ahead. Pull up jumper. No good. Jones with the rebound. And I believe Eads will just back off. Walsh will get it across the timeline. And let time expire as they dribble out the clock. That's so our final score is Walsh 54, Eads 43. We'll do a real quick recap here as soon as I get the math done. On Eads' side, it was 4 points for Tyler Rouse, 5 from Kyle Crow, 3 out of Trent Mitchek, 3 from Dylan Dixon, 4 from Jose Ramos, 9 for Logan Smith, 13 from Corey Miller, and 2 by Logan Crawford. Walsh's scoring goes like this, 10 points for Tanner Thompson, 12 from Christian Alvarez, 4 points from Jordan Johnson, 15 by Chaz Hebbard, and 13 from Chase Mundell. We will step out for about an hour, get ourselves ready for the championship semifinal session here from the Lamar Community Building, the 49th annual Lamar Holiday Basketball Tournament on ColoradoPreps.tv and Chassa.tv, presented this year by the Holiday Motel, located 404 North Main here in Lamar. I'm Kerry Sherman from Big Time Small Town Media. Hope to have you with us for tonight's games.